In the last video, we went over how we can control the altitude of the virtual helicopter. However, we had a problem with the helicopter's horizontal position control. Due to the tail rotor, the helicopter keeps moving to the right side. In this video, we will fix this by controlling the cyclic pitch of the helicopter. Then eventually our helicopter can navigate to any desired position. Without any delay, let's get into it. Alright guys, this is Elliot again from Ubicoders and welcome back to my video. And in this video, let's just talk about the cyclic pitch control of this helicopter. So if we just want to move around this helicopter as before, what I would do is just make it take off and then control the pitch angle of the tail rotor so that I can control the heading of the helicopter. Now it's moving, so let's try to move left, but it doesn't really move left, although I click the left side of this circle to control the pitch. So this indicator here is actually not controlling the attitude directly. Instead, it's controlling the pitch angle, the maximum pitch location, the azimuth angle of the helicopter. If it is first time, talk about cyclic pitch control of the helicopter. Let's just talk about this briefly. Previously, we have seen how the helicopter can generate the lift. And then this is the graph of this helicopter from the top view. And this is the lift distribution. So I'm going to just define the azimuth angle of the helicopter, and that's 0. And then that direction is 90. And towards the front, that was 180. And towards the left of the helicopter, that's 270 degrees. And then 360 and so on. On the right hand side, there's the same azimuth angle defined like this. As you can see, there are color difference there. And that's because the lift on the tip of the blade is the maximum, and that's because the free stream velocity is actually linear velocity. And then if you want to convert this angular velocity of the blade in terms of a linear velocity, if you want to convert that, you just need to multiply radius of this blade with the angular velocity, and that's going to be the free stream velocity. So lift equation is proportional to free stream velocity square, and then free stream velocity here in the helicopter's case is going to be r squared and omega squared. So that's why the lift is distributed like this. So lift generated at the root of the helicopter blade is really low, and then as we go to the direction of the span of the blade, has higher lift. Now we know how this helicopter can move up and down, but how can it move left and right and back and forth? And that's because of the device called swashplate. And then swashplate is here. And then as the swashplate moves, the pitch angle of the blade is controlled at every azimuth angle. That's how you can variate the pitch angle of the blade. So it means you can actually change the blade pitch angle, and then at a certain azimuth angle, you can give maximum pitch. I don't know, like 5 degree pitch. Then at 0, 4 degree pitch, at 90 degree, you can give, I don't know, 3 degree pitch, then back again to 4 degree pitch. As the pitch angle goes up, you will have higher lift because the lift is a function of some other values, and then CL of alpha. Alpha is angle of attack, and angle of attack can be changed by the pitch angle. So if you give higher pitch angle, you'll have higher lift. And this picture, at 270 degrees, the lift is highest. Helicopter will move to the right side direction, right? We need to talk about the gyroscopic precession. So let's switch your gear. Now let's imagine there is a satellite orbiting around the Earth like this. And then let's say at this very moment, this satellite emits some fumes to the downward in this image, and they will have force to that direction. And then the interesting thing is the satellite is actually under the circular motion, so it's not going to just teleport all the way all of a sudden to this position. Instead, the satellite is still following this current orbit, but because of the force, it will move a little bit towards the top right side of it while it's following the orbit. So eventually the orbit of the satellite will be changed like this. We just give a force at this direction to upside. And then after 90 degree shifted phase, the position of this orbit is maximum 90 degree after this force action. And this is called gyroscopic precession. Why am I talking about this? This is the same analogy for the helicopter disc. So disc is just a rotating blade really fast. Then we give maximum force at this part. Just like satellite analogy, we give a force upward outside of screen, and then the disc maximum position will happen at here. Like this, same analogy as satellite. Left-hand side of the helicopter is giving the maximum force, just like satellite emitted the fume at this position. And then helicopter disc, just like satellite orbit, will tilt towards the front side of the helicopter, and then the helicopter can move forward. If you want to move forward in the helicopter, you want to give maximum lift 90 degrees before the point where you want to pitch up the disc or nose down your helicopter. And that's because of gyroscopic precession, and you need to consider this as a control engineer. As an example, let's look at this video. This person put a slow-mo camera on the blade of the helicopter, and then as you can see, this pitch angle of the blade keeps changing as it rotates. And then let's try to pause here. Okay, go away. Try to pause here. Okay, that's the tail boom of the helicopter, and then around that position the pitch angle is maximum. So let's say from the top view of this helicopter, somewhere around here is the maximum pitch, max pitch. Now it means the disc's top position will happen 90 degrees after this point. So it's going to be top at here, max position. It means disc is tilt towards the front left of the helicopter. Again, that means this helicopter in this video is probably moving that direction. Hey guys, this is Elliot. If you find this video helpful, please like, share, subscribe for more tutorials and tips on robotics engineering. All right, let's do this again and try to control pitch up for the tail rotor, and then, okay, inclining towards front. No, go to left, go to left. But I just can't really think in real time about the gyroscopic precession and then just give the right control input. So we need to implement this in Python. So let's stop this, turn off the manual, and reset. So continuing from the code from the last section, I'm just going to comment in all these codes. Now what it does is simply controlling the velocity of the position. And again, it's a bunch of PID controller. And then the only interesting part here is that unlike multi-rotor, we need to control the azimuth angle, the max pitch angle of this helicopter disc, and that part is done here. So cyclic vector is being calculated by the required set point to correct this attitude. So that's the top position of the disc for this its own maximum point of the disc. And then after all that, subtracting 90 degrees because we need to take into account of this gyroscopic precession. And then it's just a proportional gain of this cyclic pitch. That's the cyclic azimuth angle and pitch angle, and then it will be passed again. It's just maintaining its own position straight up. Let me try to run this. To do that, I will run this bridge. And it's not going to work because we need to source it first. Source. Let's get into robot WS and then source. Install. Set up the bash. Run this, then again, cd robot ws source install setup the bash. Then copy this thing and paste it. Then we just need to connect it. That is going up straight. We turn this off, and then as you can see, this cyclic pitch and the azimuth angle is being controlled in real time by this Python code. And then it's doing its best to control all this attitude of the helicopter. So it can maintain its altitude and XYZ position, not just altitude, so that the helicopter can be inside of this magic circle, because this magic circle is just straight up from the starting point of the helicopter. If I reset this again, but it will still do the same thing, because what it does is just blindly controlling the position of the helicopter to be at the center of this magic circle. Let's try to stop it, and this time let's change this to, I don't know, 50 meters, and then let's move forward like 60 front of the helicopter. It's going up while it's changing its attitude. And the z-axis is about negative 50, that's good. And then it's position for this is in 165. And then does it go to, moving forward because it's 60. Let's make the helicopter move further to the front. I don't know, 100. Stop it again, run this. Now helicopter should be moving forward, I believe. Yeah, it's doing its best, and I don't think the PID controller gain is not really optimal. That's why it's just moving too much in left and right. But hey, it's working, and then you can play with this coefficient of the PID controllers like this. You can play with them, and then if you have found the best optimal combination of these numbers, please comment down below. I want to know what is the optimal combination for PID. That was the helicopter control using the collective and cyclic pitch of the helicopter along with the tail rotor's pitch angle as well. So that's how you want to control this helicopter. My question is, if the helicopter's heading is changed, is this algorithm still going to work? Let me know how you think. Please comment down below. And if you like this kind of video, please hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. Your support means a lot to me so I can keep uploading this kind of videos.